Hey, Gut Fox here. Welcome to my video. Today's video is sponsored by Adrian from the Rocky series. And in no way do sponsors affect who I review. Today I'm reviewing Adrian Amos from the summer blockbuster promo. 99 speed, 99 acceleration, 99 play rec, 96 tackling, 95 man coverage, 99 zone, 96 pursuit, 95 hit power. He has secure tackler and unfakeable with toughness chem and Chicago Bears team chem. Now, he is one of the most complained about cards through this whole year because of his secure tackler on his lower overall card. Having secure tackler and unfakeable makes him pretty good against the run. The running backs won't be able to fake him out, but that doesn't matter that much right now because everybody's running on conservative that knows what they're doing, because otherwise you'll fumble every other play. With all the hip power out there right now, everybody setting their tackling on aggressive means your running back's going to put the ground, ball on the ground, twice a game, at least. So, Amos being able to be on aggressive tackle along with secure tackler makes a little bit of a difference. The fact that you can sit comfortably with an aggressive tackling squad and basically just go at the running back and cause turnovers. Interception-wise, he did okay. He still gets faked out by low passes and other glitch routes on the field. Don't expect him to play those any better than anybody other cards. So, the pursuit at 96 and all the other stats I mentioned means he's a top-end defensive back against the run. You can put him anywhere on the field and he'll be good. 82 block shed, maybe a little bit low for a linebacker. So, Amos, I'd like some of those cookies. Hit power, spec catch, catch traffic, catching. Those are 95, 80, 80, 83. Why'd I group those together? For no reason. 95 ideally would be 99, but I'd ideally have a Ferrari. That'd be kind of cool. Wouldn't you like speeding around and stuff? So there he is getting kind of near the guy, but I think the footsteps from Jalen knocked that one out. Anyways, man coverage is 95 too, but if you want to play man coverage, you're playing the wrong game. This game is not fit for you. This game is fit for zone guys and guys that don't want to lose. So don't be a loser guy and don't call man coverage guy. Amos, nice. With the unfakeable chem, like I talked about, he's not going to get faked out, but there still are issues with left trigger, right trigger spins where they're more spacing based than animation based, so you can still get around them that way. Nice move going to the ball. He is a hawk back there, a very fast descending hawk, always at the top of the cover three, descending down upon its prey. He is an ideal bird of prey with that speed. Returning the ball at 99 speed is pretty glitchy. So I hope you guys pick yourselves up in Amos. Unless you have Sean Taylor and Doug Peterson, then there's no need for this card. Because Sean Taylor has 99 hit power already, and he can get up to 99 speed. So you don't need Amos, because speed is the most important stat on this game. Even against man coverage and whatnot. Look how bad that man coverage was. We needed Amos to come and sweep up for us. So playing the deep safety, you can't get much better. This guy's like the ultimate keeper or sweeper if you were playing football, Australian style. No, I mean European style. Australian football, something completely different. All right, guys. I hope you guys like this thrilling review. I had a good time with this car, but I ended up having to sell him back because I've got too many defensive backs as it is. And you know what they say about too many cooks? Amos, though, I think he's a great card. You're going to love him. I'm going to give him a 9.6 because I like him a lot. Thanks for watching. Call to action. I'll see you tomorrow.